just wondering, what would you think about a Brentwood inaugural games?
Really?
The inaugural games are starting this year.
Yes, yeah, starting
this
year.
And then you want it to roll on each
yes,
year.
Yes, correct.
What sort of games are involved?
Well, that's the thing. You love to
like a Highland games? Crossing the caper?
Well, similar. What would you think?
Would you like
to be a participant, or would you prefer to be someone who onlooker, someone who watches?
I could be a judge or a spectator.
A judge or a spectator? Yeah.
Expert spectator.
What field would you be?
Cup of tea and a sticky bun.
I love that. Sounds good to me. I don't expect much.
No, but you've got to give me a bit more about what you're playing.
Well, that's it. We'll come back to
and
you.
And I can be there.
We will come back to you.
You know, I've got a busy program, but I think I could be there.
Well, we can make sure that there's a cup of tea and a sticky bun on the table when you're there.
Okay.
Take it easy. Have a good one, mate.
G'day everyone and welcome to the inaugural Brentwood Games of 2018. We're your hosts and your commentators, Liam Peddle and Hamish here. Today you'll be seeing a series of events featuring three different boys from Brentwood, and let's meet those boys now. We'll head down to our commentator, Mr. Weber, who's down at ground level to check out the conditions for us.
Yeah, thanks boys. Certainly am excited. Shaping up to be a fantastic day. Weather's looking great. Crowds are static. A lot of excitement in the atmosphere. I think we're in for a pretty good show.
Cheers for that, Weber. We'll now cross down to our referee to do the coin toss to see who will perform first.
You!
This is a Travis Barker production.
Soldier Boy too. Hey, I got the new dance for y'all called the Soldier Boy. You gotta punch, then crank back three times from left to right.
Pleased to meet you. Boys, today you're going to have a real good clean game. It's really important to understand the rules, okay?
Yeah.
Alright, so we're just about to go through the coin toss. So Jaxon, your tails. Owen, your heads. And Ben? You're going to be going.
It's time for the coin toss now.
So we're getting to the first event now, which will be ghosting as badge famous by Hamish and Andy.
So the name of the game is follow someone around the schoolyard. You get two attempts each, and if you get caught, the timer will stop. Whoever can last the longest wins. Simple as that.
Down to ground level now with Mr. Weber.
Coming off a pretty long break, how's the off-season been?
I've been practicing heaps, to be honest. Yeah, I've been doing lots of work, so...
Just ghosting in straight lines recently?
Oh, pretty much, yeah.
You've picked a big target, Parks. He does cast a fair shadow. Should help.
Correct. He's a bit slow as well, so yeah. I reckon I can keep up with him too.
I think you're a good chance, mate. Let's stop talking. Let's get into it.
Yeah, no worries.
Righto, thanks very much, Weber. Here we go with Ben Paydon for the first ghost of the day. Just a little shooter here from Nathan Peddle.
This is going to be huge stuff, Hamish. I cannot wait for this. Ghosting is beginning right now. Brentwood Games, we've been waiting for this.
Yes, we have.
I'm almost jumping out of my seat.
And let's go. Let's see what he can do here, Ben. Just making his way into the locker back here. Parksy, standing stationary.
The clock begins, and this is dangerous. Stationary Parksy, you want him moving, and he's parked himself in the locker back.
Yes, parked behind Parksy. How's that one for you, Lee?
Pretty good.
He's seen the camera there, and he's seen Ben.
Parksy. Just been ghosted. Pretty poor effort from Paydon. I suppose you'd expect nothing less.
bring him over here.
Good tap, Parks. He might let you go, mate.
Thanks, yeah.
Go back down to ground level now with Jaxon.
Jaxon, we've just saw Benny's first attempt. Pretty hard. Did pick a hard target. Are you going to go, you're going to up the odds and go a teacher too, or maybe start off easy and pick a student?
I reckon I'll go the student. I'm always confident with Big Benny over there, mate.
What do you think's the main area you can improve on from Benny's effort?
Well, Benny's quite a large lad, so his footsteps are quite loud. I reckon I'll go this more quieter.
He does have a massive hood on him. Let's hope your little fairy boy fares a little bit better. Let's go.
Well, the stage is set here for Jaxon, and after Ben's weak effort of 10 seconds, he can really capitalise on that and take a lead going into the first round.
Yeah, Jackson's found a big group here. Could be risky. A bit more risk of being found out, potentially, but let's see how he goes.
Yeah, just a slow pace going on here. So this could play into Jackson's strategy, as he said in the interviews there. A slower pace, slower footsteps.
Yeah, Jaxon following in the footsteps of fellow Ranger here as well. We don't know, he doesn't like that nickname, but, you know, can't deny it. He is a Ranger.
He is indeed a Ranger, as we go to 25 seconds now. And he's really just monstered Ben's first attempt. Yes. But he wants to expand on that now.
Keeping slow pace, almost casual, nonchalant here from Jaxon. And he's making beautiful time, isn't he?
He is. There's a group of mates here of Jaxon coming up here. Could they disrupt him?
Down the stairs now. Jaxon doing well. He's made it body halfway across the school at this rate.
45 seconds. This is outstanding for a first attempt. And that will be it. 46 seconds.
He's still going. He fancies himself here, Jaxon. Trying to grab an extra second.
Stop, mate. No, he's still
off,
going.
Jaxon. What are you doing, mate?
Bloody hell. He's still going.
Yeah, come on.
She was. Well, nonetheless, 46 seconds. That is a
great effort now. Pretty epic,
your first effort there, mate. I think you've gone about 25 kilometres.
Yeah, very far.
How are you feeling? You're tired for that one?
Yeah, long trip, wasn't it?
It's going to be very hard to beat on your second.
Second, you're having two attempts.
Two attempts each.
As long as I make bloody paper.
Good to see you back in your best form. Cheers, mate.
Good attempt from Jaxon there, and we'll just go into Owen's first ghost now.
Mate, how you feeling making your debut in the Ghostly tournament?
A bit nervous. It's going to be a bit hard to top Gervas' effort, but you know, he kind of went for the easy picking, so I'm aiming a bit higher this time.
That's probably classic Jaxon as we know him. Loves the glory but doesn't actually pick much of a difficult task.
Exactly. I mean, that's why he didn't do Svesh. He is doing further instead. He wants to get the high score. I'm a huge fan of that.
Teacher or student, what are you going to pick?
I'm a bit of an opportunistic person, so I reckon the highest bidder around.
Let's go.
Righto, here's Owen in for his first ghost. Bit of a long-winded interview there, not sure what he was on about. It's classic Owen, isn't it, really?
It is, and here's Mr. Phillips going into the office, perhaps a change of attire now. As we know, he's made famous by his appearances in the Spotlight website for his costumes.
Yes,
perhaps. Into the office now.
Gee, the audacity of Owen venturing in there. Yeah, camera through the window, yeah, good camera work. Ooh, oh, gee.
Clock stops there. He would have hoped for more, but he was really, his arms are tied there.
Four attempt from Owen.
As we go to the instant replay, we see down the window there, he's keeping a fair distance. We're going to allow it, but he'd want to watch that for future ones.
Yes. Right,
our intern here is going to go and interview him now. Yes. Hell.
Down to Nathan. Here we go.
You're here as a suspect, and you've just been ghosted. How do you feel?
I feel pretty good, thanks.
You feel pretty good? Yeah. We've heard it here from the man himself. Let's go, boys.
Gee, well, intern commentator there, not sure about him. How did he get the gig? Not sure, but we'll go back down to Ben Paydon now.
Coming off the back of a little bit of a disappointing start.
Correct.
Strategy, change of strategy this time around.
Look, I do believe I'm going to have to maybe go the student, but I'll keep my options open.
Student ghosting could be a lot easier.
Yeah.
Could be a potential target on
there. I think I found one right now.
Don
the teacher.
Well, there you go. He's seeing something he likes, Ben, and he's doing the little trademark dance lead in here.
Yeah, he's pumping himself up, perhaps, just getting the adrenaline flying.
Yes. The clock won't start yet.
No, yeah, he's not engaged yet. He's gone around the bin. Stewart had a sniff there.
Close but, call there. And that would have been it for Ben. That would have been curtains after his 10-second first attempt. 46 seconds of time to beat.
Righto, here we go. Time starts now, Ben. We heard Weber say earlier that Ben's got heavy footsteps, you might be able to hear him, but I don't think so. He's looking good here.
He's going alright at this stage, isn't he? He's just very wary, looking at him sidestepping.
Look in the mirror there.
Oh,
wow,
Jesus Christ!
How's that from Stewart? She stormed off as well, not having
she's a none of it, yeah. 18 seconds there. We go to the instant replay just to check that again. And you just see a little eye darting inboard there, looking at the reflection.
And 3, 2, 1, here she goes, bang!
And that was his downfall, sends him away.
Well, massive effort there. Do you think the little dance leading helped you get on board?
Oh, 100%. I do have been practicing that all pre-season, and most of the time I do that. It works. Should have done it with Parksy.
Looked a little bit shocked there when she turned around and sprung her. I thought we're used to people catching you creeping around behind them.
Yeah, look, I'm speechless, sir. Speechless.
Just exhausted from his big effort. Thanks, mate.
Good stuff from Weber there, and we'll go down to ground level with our intern commentator who's got Miss Stewart with him live now. Here you go, Nathan.
Miss, how are you?
Yeah, very well, thank you.
So, how was the experience? Did you hear him coming? Was he quiet? How was he? Tippy toe? Yeah, he's a bit like that, isn't he? Thanks for your time. See ya.
Gee, that was hard to watch. I think that might be it for Nathan. I think he's done his time.
Right, Owen, here we go with Jaxon. Looks like he's coming out of the staff room here. Perhaps he's gone and put Weber to bed there, having a little snooze at school.
I don't know where he's gone, but he's off the job at this stage. Anyway, the clock begins.
Mrs. Crow here, Jackson's picked, another teacher.
She's having a little nibble on a bicky there.
Now, Jaxon had a good first round. Let's see, maybe just play it safe here and he can secure the win.
Yeah, really, if he just continues that form, he'll be held in good stead. But Miss Stewart in the background there, look at her just turning around, worried she's being ghosted again. Yeah. And Jaxon gives a shush. Don't distract Miss
Crow. Windows coming up on this staff room. Let's see if
danger,
she uses those.
Danger. Yep.
Wow, right in his face.
Clock stops at 26.
Being caught.
We go back down to Owen now for the final ghost. Oh, here we go. Owen, it's all or nothing now. He has to beat 46 seconds. The time has come. He charges in for his first target here.
Yeah, Gene, it's quite a time to beat. Yeah, I really would be doubting if he can do it here, but let's see. He's got the music on. Perhaps that could help him.
Yeah, headphones on. He didn't do that in the first round, so let's see if that can change things for him.
Yeah, and this lad in front of you, he's making quite a bit of pace here, so let's see if Owen can keep up.
He's intent, and he's on his own. That could prove very beneficial for Owen here.
Yep, and just making his way through the courtyard here. Ooh, a bit of a speed up. Gee, Owen's
forward. He's in for a long pole here.
Yeah, he's...
Ooh, weaving, winding through the tables there. That was good stuff.
Yeah, it's just around the other six-square game in the courtyard. We know that is the inferior six-square game.
We know that, Ham. And just... still going here, Jesus Christ.
Gee, would this boy be heading for the canteen?
He could be.
Oh, gee, this is risky stuff for Owen.
50 seconds. He's getting... 50 seconds, he's just playing for fun now, Owen.
Yes, look at him, and he's
got in the line.
Bloke's none the wiser. Here's Owen. And
this
he's
could go on
just
for minutes.
Ticked over a minute. This is amazing stuff.
Oh, yeah, just in closer, he doesn't care. Showboating at this point.
No, he doesn't.
Oh, we've never seen this before. This is ghosting at its very finest.
Gee, he raises the eyebrows.
Oh, and he's been seen.
Gee,
1 minute, 8 seconds.
Brilliant stuff, Owen.
Brilliant attempt from Owen, and we'll just cross the leaderboard now.
A brilliant effort from Owen. He managed to top Jaxon's first effort of 46 seconds, and it was right at the last two. Well done.
What are you doing, Mr. Bennett?
Oh, no, you can't.
I'm a
horror.
Gee, I'm not quite sure what's going on there, but anyway, we'll press on into library looting now.
So library looting, 5 minutes on the clock. Whoever can sneak the most books into other people's belongings wins the game.
All right, boys, the day has come. Been training for this for a while now. Library looting. A little bit different to the ghosting.
Yes.
Jaxon, how are you going to approach this one today, mate?
I don't know. Got to be a bit silent, I guess.
Silent and sneaky, you should be pretty good at that.
Yep, stealthy, that's me.
Benny, a lot of talk after the last ghosting incident that Jaxon might have had the edge on you. I feel library looting lends itself to your skills. What are your thoughts?
That's exactly right. A lot of people don't actually know, but I've been training for this one. I went actually to Monash Library the other day and actually went to Wheelers Hill Library too, and I've practiced a lot, so expect big things.
And very much the dark horse this year, actually. Started a bit late, but started very strongly. Have you library looted?
Ooh, like, I don't have to train, it just happens naturally. I don't have to do it in the library, I do it in all classes. They call me the Shadow.
I think they should call in the bloody chatterbox, because he doesn't shut up, does he? Oh, mate, good luck.
Right, here we go. Of course, the timer will start as soon as the first book is picked up here. So 5 minutes on the clock.
Yep.
Just waiting for them to get over to the books.
That's filing and looking ominous, isn't it, Lee?
It is.
Just see who's crowding first.
Yes. There's the clock picked up as Ben Payne's picked up that orange, pinkish book there. Just assessing the situation, finding his target.
Quite a large one to start. We'd like to see how Ben slips this one in. He's gone for a fellow Year 12 here. Is that be Geenot or Seenot?
I don't know. Jeez. I really do not know. It's a mystery. Can't see the glasses too well there. But anyway, we move on. He's going to dodge that one. He wasn't too sure about it. As we see there, Geenot was looking on, or Seenot, and he's thought, not worth the risk.
Yes. Here's Owen. He's straight into the action in the middle. Perhaps tying the shoelace. That's a good tactic. We haven't seen that in a few years, have we?
Outstanding stuff. The presence of mind to go for that one. He's just waiting.
Yeah, and over to Ben now on the other side. He's leaned down. I think going for a bit of a chat here. Hand on the table. Owen now. You can see Ben on the other side. And Owen's racked up a point there.
Ding. First point of the game. And BP there just checking out the folder. And he's snuck it on there. That was stealthy stuff, really.
Exceptionally brilliant from Ben. Let's see what else is going on here. Gervo now, he's yet to rack up any points, but let's see if he can get himself on the board here. Just a quick sneak.
Easy pickings, the bloke wasn't even looking. Owen, got a new book here, and BP also.
Back in for the kill already, Ben. He's looking to rack up the points quickly, isn't he?
He's showing good stamina here to just, again, the presence of mind, just really in the game.
Owen in the distance, and would I be right in saying that's the same boy that Owen got the book on
there? It could be. And that book's gone. As the camera was off and he's hit that book, well done, Ben.
Right in there. Here's Jaxon now on the other side of the library on his own. Perhaps good, less attention drawn.
It is a good tactic, isn't it? All the other two, Owen and Ben.
Yeah. A bit of discussion here. What's going on? Doesn't look this, happy about this.
This might be unattended, these belongings. This is classic Jaxon as we know him.
Yes, quite the opportunist, isn't he, Lee?
Yes, he is. And he's got that thing indicates another point.
Yes. And here's Owen. Still behind the boys. Ben interfering. Perhaps want to steal the point here.
Trying to steal it, and he's not happy about it either.
One in there for Owen.
Jaxon, he knows he's done a little cheeky one there. BP sits down here.
Still lurking. Ben going for the long game, perhaps here. Sitting down, might just sneaking in. Let's see. Or Jaxon coming in for the kill as well.
Again, BP gets one there. His big frame hit any sign of hiding a book there, and he got away with it.
Jaxon's sitting on a table, I believe. Not the stealthiest.
Poor etiquette, really. Mr. Bennett wouldn't be happy with that.
And let's see what he's getting. He's checking out his opportunities, isn't he?
Assessing the situation again. As we look down on the left of the screen there, Owen drops the phone on the book. And he's got one there. Gee, that was stealthy.
Absolutely cheeky.
Jaxon still just sort of figuring out what to do.
Yeah. Perhaps he's done that one in the movies before with a girl.
That bloke's having none of it. He's got his belongings close under his arm.
Yes. Jaxon not getting a bar. Not getting a look in.
BP in an argument here. Of course, Jaxon just got this bloke. And this bloke seems to have found that book. That point still stands, but it's going to prove troublesome for BP.
What's he doing? He's still going for it. He's committed to this one, Ben. He's not wasting any time trying to make every point count.
And look at this. He says, throw that book over there. As I sneak this book in there.
Oh, no.
His mate.
No,
like a good mate. Out. Let's listen in here.
So dumb, you're retired
of
putting a book in
there. Gee whiz, well, good on the bloke for staying up to a Year 12 like him. It's worked something for them, they're just ruining the sort of reputation of Brentwood.
Yes, back to Jaxon. Looking out for his mate, quite noble. Here's Jaxon though.
Showing an interest in that laptop there, and that bloke really uncomfortable.
Oh, Jaxon seems like maybe a bit of Fortnite going on there in the library.
Wouldn't be surprised. It's time to leave, he says, as Owen. Again with the shoelace technique, it's proving really useful to him at this stage.
Pretty close, but he's racked up another point. Good work from Owen.
18. Bodied out of there, Jaxon.
Ben,
like BP.
Straight under the
iPad. The big contested beast, and Jaxon thrown out of the way. Let's listen again here. There is again. He strikes again, that boys.
Those boys holding their
guard in the library. There's a minute remaining here. Owen going in. This bloke's been gone before.
Dropped it again. Another classic Owen tactic. Oh, and the boy's a bit. He's scared, isn't he, Lee?
Timothy gets out of his seat. Do you want my seat? He says.
No. Owen says, no, I'm just here to put a book away.
He's got it wrapped around his finger.
Let's
here,
see
Owen.
If you can do it. There he is.
Oh, brilliant play, Owen. Oh, my goodness. A bonus point opportunity.
Big book here for Ben. Bonus point opportunity. But over to Jaxon. And here is Ben looking to plant that big book to snaffle an extra point up. Perhaps bring himself to the lead here.
Yeah, he's just sort of picking his target really carefully. Doesn't want to waste that opportunity. As Jackson's rejected there, the bloke hands his book back, not getting away with it.
Owen deep in the library. Not much going on there for that boy. Ben
has snuck that book in. That's plus one.
That's a bonus point that Owen got. Gee whiz.
20 seconds left. It's neck and neck.
Going off here in the library. Owen
a
just
pat on the back. Better watch that one, mate. He's underage. Has he got one?
No, no, he's seen it. No point there.
And Jaxon, here he goes. Perhaps the last second opportunity. Just distracting the boy, saying, perhaps do you like that? And no point there, and that'll do it. That's time up here. We go to the scoreboard now.
Gentlemen, the victor, Dan Webber, Brentwood Games News.
Dan Webber.
Tell us about the library looting. How did it all go?
Who the hell are you?
Who are you?
Dan Webber, head of science.
That's not Dan Webber.
Yeah, no, look, I know. Yeah, Mr. Webber, he's going to bigger, better things. He can't deal with amateur sport anymore, so he's sent me in his stead. Gentlemen, a quick word?
No, it's
we can't. We can't. We,
Dan Webber or nothing? Dan Webber or nothing?
Can I say?
Don't know where Mr. Webber's gone, but Mr. Zaki's fooling no one.
We'll go into our classroom sit-in now. So the idea with this one is sneak into a random class that you're not meant to be in and see how long you can last with the teacher not seeing you.
Down to ground level now with Ben Paydon for his first attempt.
Well, here we go. This is the first sit-in attempt for Ben. Let's see how he goes. He's entering in a closed class here. This will be interesting.
It says shush to the camera.
Shushing
up
the door, probably. What's going on here?
Yes, so in the 20th century, we were looking at two world wars, and one of them was happening much before the first one. Yes.
I'm going to leave. I'll leave you to it.
Okay.
Gee, Mr. Exton just having a bit of me time there in that room. We'll give Ben Paydon a bit of a buffer, and we'll go into Owen's sit-in now.
Here we go. Owen's first attempt at the sit-in. Unlike Ben's first attempt, the class isn't in yet, so this could play into Owen's hands here.
Man, you'd think the teacher's clearly seen him walk past. I don't know how Owen's done that. Sneaky stuff.
Brilliant stuff. Bit of band going in the class here. Yeah, he could blend in right in.
You'd definitely think that red jacket would make him stand out, though. But, yeah, it looks like he's taking a seat here, making himself comfortable in the IT lab.
21 seconds was Ben's time, 21.8 to be exact, and he's just going to clock over that now, I think. Yeah. He's hit the lead.
Good stuff from Owen here. Now, let's see. No, he's not turning the computer on. He's just taking a relaxed approach here.
Those computer screens could be useful, though. Student, they're just saying you don't belong in that class, perhaps. Growing suspicious.
Gee, it's a bit of a ruckus going down in this class as well. Owen fit right in being a pretty loud student himself.
That's just saying, he could hide behind those computer screens. That's probably how we're going to fast forward here.
Gee, it is. Yeah, he's making good time here,
this
Owen.
This is a big time for a first attempt.
Good stuff. Let's just see how long he can last. He looks at the camera there, gives a little nod and a thumbs up. How's that?
Wondering what to do. Owen answers the roll there. Just, again, showboating. He's growing confident after his first win in ghosting.
Just adventurous. And yeah, he's having a good chuckle. Let's see the pocket cam here. We might pick up what's going on in the class.
He's chatting to a mate here.
You can say something to the camera if you want.
Ooh.
Where are you at? Yeah, for it.
No. Oh, yeah, he offered the bloke to say something to the camera, but he turned it down. That's...
The teacher almost looking right at Owen there. Let's listen in again.
Oh, no, I don't
want to
stay in lunchtime.
A good choice there.
So,
yeah.
Class.
12 squares valuable is going to depart, and 1 minute 40 is a monstrous time.
Really solid effort from Owen there, but let's see what Ben Canoe is recomposing himself, and he's ready to go. Let's go down to him now.
Right, Owen, here we go with the first round of classroom sit-ins, going with Ben Paydon here, and we've just got the pocket cam today. It's new technology we've been introduced to this year, and it's been well utilised.
We have the in-class mic. We hear Mr. Sampford there just handing out threats left, right and centre right there, so that'd be something Ben would be worried about,
I'm,
I think.
I'm not quite sure if Ben will fit in with this Year 8 class. He's a fair bit bigger than these kids.
It's not looking good, and this bloke's coming over, he's... not sure about it, just staring right at him, drawing attention too, and ooh, that's the clock stop there, he's been noticed.
Yeah, good chat here from Sanford, we'd like to see.
Been loving
it. Tried, sir. Tried.
Yes. So, we'll see how that goes. Good sport there, Sampford, though. We like that.
Yes.
It's good stuff. 21 seconds.
So, Ben, unable to top Owen's efforts there, and we'll see what Jaxon can do now. He's down there, ready to go.
Righto, here we go. Jaxon just slips into the class late here for his final sit-in attempt. First and final, should I say. Yeah. We only get one attempt at this game, so here we go.
Science room here, and he's on his own at the back of the row there. Trying to blend in.
He's looking at the camera, Jaxon, nervous. We know this bloke, he has been nervous today, but let's see if he can settle the nerves and pull out a good time.
Yeah, he does get pre-game nerves, but a big time to beat from Owen. He'd be hard-pressed to beat it, really.
I know, and a few more lads joining the class here.
Teacher on the whiteboard, this is buying him some time, perhaps.
She's
oblivious.
Thank you.
Not even close to him. Oh, and he moves over. What a gentleman, Jaxon.
Like a chameleon, just blending into his environment. Moves over. I don't want to disrupt the seating arrangement, God forbid.
No, we've seen it all before.
Yeah.
Let's listen in.
I don't know, I like science.
I like science, he says. I know you don't, mate.
No, don't lie to yourself, Jaxon. I'm trying to make some friends, but let's listen again here.
Submit their slip, you just wouldn't do that.
No, you, that's foolish.
Bloody hell.
Jeez.
No doubt Jaxon would be one of those students.
Don't be fooled by what's going on in the class. Jackson's making good time here.
What's the slip? The slip?
So the slip, there's different. So there's like psychology, chemistry, and we have to do like experiment.
Right into it,
Jaxon. Oh, okay, yeah, gotcha.
Oh, still taking
it. Student-led inquiry project.
Oh, yeah, gotcha.
Teacher distracted, chasing up students.
Looks to the camera for a bit of approval.
No.
Nothing there.
Is that touchscreen?
Yeah.
Got Fortnite on that laptop.
Oh, yeah. Go on.
It's mad.
It's mad, he says. Clock's still ticking. You know what's mad, Jaxon, is you're the new winner.
No, I have a laptop.
And he's made brilliant time here. Let's see how long he can keep this up.
You know, he could have kept going for minutes there, but...
Jeez, he's made his way out.
He's disinterested and says, that'll do, I think. And he waltzes out.
He hasn't got time for it.
2 minutes on the dot.
Too easy, he says.
Congratulations, Jaxon.
Well, as we check the leaderboard from the class sitting in, I think we've got a tiebreaker, Hamish.
Yes.
Oh, boy.
Regulation's over, and I think we're going to have to go to an extra game, Liam. What
I
do you
think? Will. I think it's got to be canteen time waste.
All right. Care to explain the rules for that one?
Yes. So our three contestants will line up in the line. They'll go to the head of the canteen, and when they get up there, the clock will begin. Now, the clock won't appear in the tiebreaker, just to add a bit of suspense.
Yes. And, we like suspense.
We do. The winner of this one takes all. The winner of this one wins the Brentwood Games.
Here
Let's
we go.
Go down. Ground level with Ben Payton.
And we're on here.
Hi there, how are you?
Going for a cough here.
Ben should be good. It's a bit of a smooth talk, we know that.
Asking about the various food items.
Yeah, well, there isn't much to ask about new canteens, so don't blame the bloke. How much is this? I'll have a bit of that, he says.
Ask him for a drink. Speaking very slowly, isn't he?
Yes.
A croissant.
Biding his time here is Ben. Jin, no real pressure from the wine. He can do as he pleases here, can't he?
I'm touching the window. Don't touch the glass, please, Ben. He's buying out the whole canteen here, isn't he?
He's still going, isn't he? And
you'd hope he can pay for all of that.
Gee.
Noodle cups.
I'll just get that.
Look at that,
boy,
he says.
Ben,
he's
going to
call it there, and he's... Well, where's his wallet?
Gee, he's lost his wallet.
Is this a little tactic here?
He's looking around.
Let's listen in.
Oi, Cam, do you have my wallet?
Oh,
can
come
you take
on.
My wallet?
Canteen
lines are watching on in awe.
Lucky no one's pushed in there. That would be end of time, but...
No, he's done it, and they've got all the food out, and he's just left empty-handed.
Ah, the clock would stop there, and that's a good effort from Ben.
Well, there's nothing more Ben can do now. His job's done. No timer, of course. We don't know how he's gone there, but we'll see how Jaxon goes now. He's down there ready.
Here we go for Jaxon's attempt at the canteen time waste to hit.
Hey, ho.
It'd be hard to do better than Ben. Here we go.
Pardon? Oh, it's fine.
What did she say? A sneeze.
Valuable time taken up there for Jaxon.
What about the one behind it?
He's making himself at home here, isn't he? Really leaning his head in the window.
Yeah,
getting the full canteen
really
experience.
Again, applying the technique to ask about
the
food items.
In the What's in that one in the bowl?
There's halves and Brentwood.
Have a look at those.
In all the
cheese as well.
He's not afraid to show it.
I might just get that one, yeah.
Yeah, a bit of tomato and cheese. You don't build calves like that without a bit of tomato and cheese in your diet, so it's a good call from Jaxon.
Yeah, that's it, thanks. I'll just go get my wallet. Vans.
What's he doing?
Well, if someone pushes in here, that would be the end of the timer. This bloke's edging forward.
Here we go.
Wallet's still in limbo. He's moved in.
That'd be timer stopped, wouldn't it?
There. It's all academic at this point.
Still can't find his wallet. Here he goes.
Yeah.
Right in there. Getting pushed around by unions.
No, Jaxon.
Can I just pay $5 note?
Afraid that won't count, mate. The timer had stopped. $5 note, you can pay with that, mate. That is money.
Thank you.
You collect your food and get out of there.
That'll be it. We wait to see how he goes there, but I'm sure.
Huh?
Yet again, we don't know how Jackson's gone there, but here we go down to Owen for the final ever Brentwood game for 2018. Let's go.
Well, here we go. It's come to this. The final go. The final event. It's a tiebreaker. The final. I'm waiting patiently. The time hasn't begun yet.
The final game here of the Brentwood Games 2018. And, you know, this is the end of this year, but maybe next year we have another one.
You never know. Here we go. A little coughing fit to waste time.
Sorry.
And she's asked for next,
no,
please.
No.
I'm
not having it.
A pizza roll, please.
Pizza roll, good choice.
Actually, sorry, I'll make a garlic.
Is that all she says? She says, you might need a bit more food than that, Owen. You're a pretty big-looking boy.
Steady on. Just wasting time. She's giving her nothing here. Not a lot to work with for Owen.
And,
He did pick the left side of the canteen.
What drink do you recommend?
What drink do you recommend? Whatever you want, she says.
Iced tea, please. Lemon.
Shut down.
Yeah.
Ben and Jaxon got the nice little canteen lady, and this lady, she's just going about her job promptly.
Quite
doesn't want to waste any time. Can't fault
it. 50. Maybe we'll count these ones out, see if you can waste a little bit more time.
Yes.
Here.
If he was a real player, he'd drop some coins here, but we'll see how he goes.
Has he? No, he hasn't.
Thank
he's
you.
He's just collecting his items.
He's paid for it.
A tentative thank you. Clock's still running at this stage. It's going to be tight here. It's going to be real tight in the tiebreaker.
Gee, you think maybe that's not down to Owen, it's more the canteen lady's fault, but
it's going to be very tight. Well, there we go, it's a tight contest. I don't know, I can't pick it from here, I really cannot.
No, it's all come down to this, and I think we'll just check out the leaderboard now, Liam, so let's go live to that.
Let's go to it. There we go, Ben Paydon is the winner. It's a great effort from him. 1 minute and 25 seconds it was in the canteen time waste.
It's a big honour for the young man, isn't it? The first ever winner of the
Brentwood
Games.
It is a huge honour.
I think we'll just cross down now to Miss Allan for the medal present.
We will. We want to say thank you for watching, and we hope we may see you at Brentwood Games again next time.
Cheers.
Congratulations, Benjamin. You have been crowned the
victor
of the inaugural Brentwood Games 2018. Mr. Rogers has been looking for you everywhere. Get to Seacock at once.
Oh, Mr. Rogers.
Hi, Ben. How are you? All right, thanks. Look, congratulations. You've won the Brentwood Games.
Yes, thank you.
Congratulations. A worthy winner.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We couldn't find a sticky bun, but this is the closest we could find. A banana muffin.
Look, mate. I was looking forward to a sticky bun.
What? Okay.
Mr. Rogers has been looking for you everywhere. Get to Seacock at once.
Yeah. 30 seconds.
or nothing. Down, web or nothing.
Ben, Brody Ryan. Ryan, what's the word? Live leading.
So Jaxon, your tails. Owen, your heads. And Ben.
Come on, double. Hey! We got a mister!